North Walk of Primitive. Welcome back to another Cooking with the Sarge. I got another one of my favorites I like to take with me out in the woods all the time. I'll show you how to cook it up. Basically what it is, it's a beef jerky in gravy. And we're going to make some gravy out here and cook the beef jerky. And as you all need to know, I like to take a lot of beef jerky with me. I like to make it on my own and bring it out. So we're going to go ahead and cook up some beef jerky. Got my canteen cup. I'm going to get it down here in the coals. What we're going to do is we're going to reconstitute that beef jerky. The beef jerky's been dehydrated and dried out, so it's tough, but we want to make it more like regular meat. So all we're going to do is we're going to boil up some of this water. Put some water in there. I got maybe a half a canteen cup in there. And then we're going to throw this beef jerky in there. And what that's going to do is it's going to reconstitute. It's going to soak up some of that water. It's going to get soft and more pliable, more like regular meat. Just like a little bit of regular beef cooked up in there. And once this gets all reconstituted and the water starts to boil, we'll be back and I'll show you how to make the gravy. Okay, cool. We're back now. The water's been boiling for a while, reconstituting this beef jerky. And the great thing about reconstituting, I mean, you can take beef jerky out to the woods with you. It's still something good to eat. But ideally, if you can, you want to boil it down in some water, because what's going to do is that's going to actually break up that nutrients. One, it's going to soften the meat up and make it easier for your body to digest it and get more nutrition out of it. Two, when you boil something in water like this, you're releasing all that nutrients and all those calories and even all that fat into the water, which is going to help your body absorb more nutrients and more nourishment just from drinking that water. And on top of that, too, you got yourself a nice flavored brothy meal. If you're out in the cold like this and you need to get warmed up, it's much nicer to have something tasty and that tastes good. So now that we got it boiling pretty good and it's pretty much reconstituted, I'm going to go ahead and start making the gravy. Now, anybody who watches all my videos knows I love to carry basically pancake mix with me everywhere I go. And when I got this little container here, I like to keep my pancake mix in. Small little container, doesn't take up much space. And I got a couple meals. I got at least two meals just in this case, in this little container alone. And when I got in here, I knew specifically why I was going to be making this, so I took this pancake mix and I actually mixed in some black pepper and some garlic salt in it to give it a little bit more flavoring. So we're going to go ahead and start making our gravy. Now, we're not just dumping this whole thing in because we don't want to make a big soupy mess. We're just going to add a little bit over time, stir it in, just like making instant gravy at home. Or gravy with flour. I'm just going to add a little bit in and stir it up. I'm just going to stir in. Start stirring in that gravy. I'm going to pull it up off the heat here. There we go. Just a little bit of that gravy mix at a time. Get it mixed in there, get all the clumps breaking up. It's going to start thickening up that water. Don't want to put too much in at a time because then you just end up with a big clumpy mess. Now you don't have to flavor, you know, the pancake mix. You don't have to put anything in it. You can just use regular flour too. You can use bannock, anything you want. It's going to act as a thickening agent. Get out of the smoker. Make this gravy nice and thick. And I like my gravy thick. Big fan of black pepper. That's why I got black pepper in there. And you can see I'm not even using that whole entire thing, so I still have another meal left there. Gonna let that sit for a minute, let it cool down, and let it thicken up on its own. Alright, cool, we're back. I actually put this on the heat just for a little bit more time, just thicken it up, and as you can see, we got a really nice thick gravy going on there. I'm telling you, this is one of my favorite meals right here. Give this a little taste. Oh man, that's so good. Plenty of pepper in there. And that meat is nice and soft now. Reconstitute it, and all that meat boiled in that water It broke out all that nutrients and all that, all those calories into that broth, into that gravy. And as you can see, I didn't even use half that container, so I still got another one to two meals with just this. So just a little bit of beef jerky, container of this of a pancake mix or Bisquick, anything like that. Even if you make your own bannock, you take it out with you. You can make plenty of meals if you find anything naturally that you can eat, whether it's a meat source or even if it's winter now, but if you found some berries or something like that, you could definitely make yourself a good meal with a little bit of water. So that's Sergeant Speakman's beef jerky and gravy video. So I'm going to say goodbye for now, and I'm going to enjoy this. So thanks for watching. Mm.